This is Dawson Meadows with the Video Wire, and here's what's out there. Well, I've tried really hard to stay off the national political scene. Lord knows it's getting enough publicity as it is, but no matter how much we try to avoid it, like a sunburn, like poison ivy, mixing wine and whiskey, it happens, and we all succumb to the pressures of the news, social media, the blab-fuckery mouth vomit that comes raining in on us like hail in certain sections of Fort Smith last week. Well, now we've got one less to worry about as Ted Cruz announces his running mate, Carly Fiorina, and then bows out of the race completely. Okay. Look, between me, you, and the wall, I never really liked Cruz anyway. I mean, he was literally the Saturday Night Live version of himself every time he talked. I mean, he's like a fake evangelical preacher on one of those weird channels. So now what? Well, experts claim that we should now jump on the Trump train, which I think is trending or something, isn't it? Yeah, okay. Well, while others are turning their eyes to Bernie Sanders, it's become very clear to us here at the Video Wire that Biff from the future and Doc Brown are running for president. And honestly, if you look at it this way, it actually makes the whole situation a whole lot more fun to process. I mean, hell, even Elaine is trying to run for office. This is the future, folks. More on this year's presidential election on every fucking channel there is. Killing me. In local news, we turn our attention to the month of May to celebrate Fort Smith Western Heritage Month. This is a month-long celebration of our Western heritage that ends with the Old Fort Days Rodeo. You can go to thingstodoinfortsmith.com to see a complete list, but here are a few things to highlight. The Fort Smith Trolley Museum will run each day downtown, and alternating weekends have live robbing of the trolley performances by the Lawbreakers and Peacemakers and the Indian Territory Pistoliers, not against each other. That might be kind of cool. The Choctaw Nation Stickball event will be held on the historic grounds on May 14th. Art on the Border will be an art show held on May 28th at the Frisco Station in downtown Fort Smith. And on the same day, the 28th, at Harry E. Kelly Riverfront Park, join Things to Do in Fort Smith and Kisser 93 on the river for the third annual Judge Parker's Rope War. This is a 10-person team tug-of-war tournament with the winner taking home the sought-after golden noose. Yes, this is indeed a golden noose. People pay attention when you walk into their office with this, just FYI. Go to ropewar.com. Only the team captain has to sign up. You don't have to have all 10 names of every member on there. You don't even have to pay until the day of the event. So, very simple to do. It's only $100 and all will go to the Rodeo Scholarship Fund. So there, ropewar.com. Last year we had World Class Fitness take home the golden noose. The year before that it was the Next Level. I tell you what, I know that there are some folks out there at Planet Fitness. Is there any people in Fort Smith that go to Planet Fitness? Oh, yes, yes. Every single person in Fort Smith goes to Planet Fitness. So I'm asking you guys to form your 10-person team. I have something in my eye. To form your 10-person teams and get over to ropewar.com and sign up. More things to do in May at thingstodoinfortsmith.com. This is Dawson Meadows with the Video Wire. I appreciate every like, comment, share, tweet, retweet, snapperated. Snapchatted up. I hate Snapchat. Okay, whatever, damn kids. Until next week, enjoy this beautiful weather. Until next week, enjoy this beautiful weather outside. We're Until next week, enjoy this beautiful weather we're having out there. And remember, this stash and beard is for you. Okay, that's I'm done. Boy, look at me in my face. Tell me that you're not just about this.